Yeah, so this is...
This is a brand new puncheon. The one that last one was 1 year old.
Yeah.
Mercury puncheon. They're CLL Plus, which is sort of their Burgundy Chardonnay barrel.
Yeah.
Their Merceau barrel.
Yeah, I'm going to say it's like a nutty Merceau.
Yep. Yeah. And so this is Clone 95 from 06 plantings. So yeah. Starting to hit their stride at 10 years old in this wine. Again, 100% wild. All of the Chardonnay this year did Malo before primary had finished. So it was one of those weird ones where we packed it away for the winter and then in the spring it finished off.
So when you say it's 100% wild, you're because what in the end? Do you think it's going to give you something totally different?
To me, every barrel has a slightly different population. So we get complexity through every barrel being slightly different as opposed to one big population straight into the wine.
Okay.
I also think it's more to do with the kinetics of the fermentation. So it's slowly starting and you've got non-saccharomyces doing work to start with before the saccharomyces takes over. But I've done a lot of research with UBCO and with Daryl Brooker and with Grant Stanley and a couple of others. Severine's been part of that as well, and Nikki from Farmscape has, where we look at which species are actually doing the work in a closed environment like the barrel. Yeah. And invariably, it's a commercial strain that ends up finishing it off. So it's more an ambient ferment than it is a wild ferment, but it's more that kinetics of not giving it a big population to start with and letting it build its own diverse population.
So this will be another part of the blend, like the previous one.
Mm-hmm.
Will it be a bigger or a smaller part of the new oak?
I've already blended up the younger Chardonnay, and that's already in bottle.
Yeah.
And then this is all going together as one. As an elevage, as we'll see. If we have to make some cuts, we will. But
cool. Thanks, Dave.
Cool. Cheers.
Yeah.